Are we just code? Exploring the simulation theory. Imagine that the reality you know is not the ultimate base reality, but a meticulously crafted digital construct, a cosmic video game where advanced beings run simulations to study their past or simply for entertainment. Hello and welcome to the Life Pulse. Today we're diving headfirst into one of the most mind-bending ideas ever proposed, the possibility that everything we experience, our world, our history, even ourselves, is part of a grand simulation. Sounds like something out of science fiction, right? But as we'll see, there are plenty of intriguing clues that might just make you wonder. Are we living inside a computer program? Let's start by exploring what simulation theory is all about. In essence, simulation theory proposes that a sufficiently advanced civilization could create an artificial universe. A digital realm so detailed that its inhabitants wouldn't know the difference from real life. Think about your favorite video games. When you play a game like Civilization or The Sims, you're immersed in a world that looks, feels, and behaves like a real one, even though it's just lines of code. Now scale that idea up to the entire universe. What if our universe is essentially a hyper-advanced simulation run by beings whose technology is light years ahead of ours? To break it down, imagine two layers of reality. The primary reality, where the simulation is actually being computed, and the secondary reality, our everyday world, where we see walls, stars, and everything else. In video games, every object is programmed with specific rules. A character can't walk through a wall because the game's code says so. When it comes to our everyday lives, we trust that a wall is solid even though, at the atomic level, it's just a complex arrangement of particles following precise physical laws. We see the end result, which is a seamless, tangible world, without ever peeking behind the curtain of code. One fascinating aspect of simulated worlds is how they fool us into believing they're real. When game designers create a virtual world, they work on three levels: immersion, absorption, and saturation. In our simulation hypothesis, the creators have programmed our universe to be consistent and believable. For instance, consider how you naturally expect a house's layout to be consistent. Even if a character suddenly exits the frame, you assume they'll reappear somewhere logical. This world gestalt, or overall configuration of reality, pausi, is crucial in maintaining the illusion that our digital world is concrete and fully rendered, even if in truth it might only be loaded piece by piece. Much like how a modern video game only renders the environment in your immediate field of view. Imagine you're wearing a virtual reality headset. The system only displays what's directly in front of you, while areas outside your view are left unrendered until you turn around. This approach saves computational resources. Now suppose our universe works the same way. Only the parts of reality that we're actively observing are fully rendered, while distant regions remain in a low-resolution state until we focus on them. It's a tantalizing thought. Could the cosmos be optimizing its processing power by loading details only as needed? One of the most famous arguments in favor of simulation theory comes from philosopher Nick Bostrom. He suggests that one of three possibilities must be true. One, civilizations like ours tend to go extinct before developing the technology to run realistic simulations. Two, advanced civilizations do achieve this technology but decide not to run such simulations. And three, we are almost certainly living in a simulation. If we assume that technological progress will eventually allow for the simulation of entire universes, and that post-human civilizations might run countless such simulations, then statistically it becomes far more likely that we're inside one of these digital experiments than in the original base reality. In other words, if there are billions or even trillions of simulated realities, our odds of being part of the original are incredibly slim. Now, let's get a bit quirky. Have you ever experienced a moment of déjà vu, a sudden, eerie feeling that you've already lived this exact moment? Or perhaps you recall a famous movie line or a logo slightly differently than it appears today. Some people refer to these peculiar instances as glitches in our reality. Imagine for a moment that you're playing your favorite video game and suddenly the game stutters or a character momentarily freezes. In a simulated universe, similar hiccups could occur. These tiny anomalies might be evidence of the underlying code, unexpected moments when the simulation resets or updates. For example, the Mandela Effect describes how large groups of people remember events or details differently from how they actually occurred, such as misremembered movie quotes or brand names. While our brains are naturally prone to memory quirks, some simulation theorists argue that these collective misrememberings are hints of alterations in the program's code. I remember a time when I experienced an uncanny familiarity in a place I'd never visited. It was as if a scene from a movie was replaying, but then it shifted in unexpected ways. Moments like these make you wonder, are we witnessing a brief debug in our reality? Let's shift gears to a famous physics experiment often mentioned by simulation theory theorists, the double slit experiment. In this experiment, particles such as electrons are fired at a barrier with two openings. When not observed, these particles create an interference pattern on the other side, a behavior that is characteristic of waves. However, when scientists try to measure which slit a particle goes through, the interference pattern vanishes and the particles behave like tiny solid objects. This mind-bending result has led some to speculate that observation itself collapses a particle's wave-like behavior into a definite state. In our simulated universe hypothesis, this could be analogous to a video game engine that only renders objects in high detail when they're being directly observed by the player. It's as if the universe decides what level of detail to provide based on our focus, an idea that blurs the lines between physics and computer science. Moreover, physicist John Wheeler proposed the delayed choice experiment, where decisions made after a particle passes through the slits appear to affect its previous behavior. In this experiment, the decision of whether to measure which path the particle takes is postponed until after the particle has already passed through the slits. Essentially, you set up your experiment so that the method of detection, or even whether you detect at all, is decided after the particle is in flight. When you decide to detect which slit the particle went through, even if that decision is made after the particle passes through, the interference pattern disappears. Instead of behaving like a wave, the particle appears to have taken a definite path, behaving more like a classical particle. On the other hand, when no attempt is made to determine the particle's path, the interference pattern remains, indicating that the particle behaved like a wave, exploring all possible paths simultaneously. The surprising part of the delayed choice experiment is that the outcome, wave-like or particle-like behavior, seems to be determined by the measurement setup, even when that setup is decided after the particle has passed the slit. It appears as if the future decision, to observe or not, retroactively influences the particle's past behavior. This retroactive influence raises even more questions about the nature of time and observation. Could our act of watching be rewriting history on the fly? Are the laws of physics programmed? Some of the most intriguing and controversial evidence comes from the realm of theoretical physics. Advanced researchers have found that the equations describing the fabric of our universe sometimes resemble lines of computer code. For example, Professor James Gates discovered what appeared to be error-correcting codes embedded within the equations of superstring theory. These codes are similar to those used in computer programs to detect and correct errors, suggesting that perhaps our physical laws are not random, but are instead part of a pre-written script. This discovery has sparked wild theories. If the universe is indeed a simulation, might its laws of physics be nothing more than programmed instructions? Could the constants of nature, the speed of light, Planck's constant, and even the golden ratio found in everything from flower petals to spiral galaxies, be the result of algorithmic design? It's a fascinating possibility that challenges our traditional notions of science and reality. Philosophy has long pondered the nature of reality, and simulation theory is no exception. Think back to Plato's allegory of the cave. In the allegory, a group of prisoners have spent their whole lives inside of a cavern, chained by their necks and ankles and facing the empty outer wall. This makes them only capable of seeing shadows on the wall and therefore assume those shadows are the entirety of reality. Similarly, our senses might only be capturing a limited shadow of the true nature of existence. We interpret our experiences based on what is presented to us, without ever seeing the full picture behind the scenes. Whether you lean towards science or philosophy, simulation theory forces us to confront profound questions. What is the nature of consciousness? If our minds can be simulated, does that change what it means to be human? And even if we are merely characters in a sophisticated digital experiment, does that diminish the value of our experiences and choices? The answer, perhaps, is that our reality, simulated or not, is the only one we have, and our lives remain precious and meaningful. Now, let's talk technology. In recent decades, computer graphics and virtual reality have advanced at a breathtaking pace. What once were pixelated worlds have evolved into immersive, near photorealistic environments. Look at how video game graphics have transformed over just a few decades. Today's games offer experiences that blur the line between the digital and the real. Now, imagine what will happen when our technology surpasses even our wildest dreams. If Moore's Law still holds some sway, and if artificial intelligence continues to grow exponentially, then one day we might be able to simulate not just a game world, but an entire universe, complete with billions of conscious beings, each experiencing their own digital life. And if that day comes, the creators of that simulation could be running countless universes simultaneously, making it statistically far more likely that we are part of one of these simulations rather than the original reality. Even now, we see early examples of simulated worlds online, massively multiplayer games where virtual societies develop, complete with economies, cultures, and even politics. It's not a giant leap from a digital playground like Minecraft or World of Warcraft to an entire universe simulated by advanced technology. In fact, some theorists argue that if our descendants ever develop the means to simulate life itself, they may well choose to explore history by creating ancestral simulations that mimic their own origins. In such a scenario, every decision and every outcome in our world could be part of a programmed narrative. Of course, it's not all dry science and philosophy. There are plenty of mysterious, almost cinematic phenomena that add to the allure of simulation theory. Have you ever noticed something strange, like an object disappearing in the blink of an eye or an unexpected shift in your surroundings? Some interpret these experiences as glitches in the simulation, a momentary lapse in the digital rendering of reality. Consider the many accounts of unexplained phenomena, eerie deja vu episodes, conflicting memories of historical events, sometimes known as the Mandela Effect, or even bizarre encounters with what appear to be UFOs defying the conventional laws of physics, a phenomenon that has been recently considered to be of interdimensional origin, but that's a subject for another video. While many of these incidents can be chalked up to our imperfect memory or misinterpretation, the simulation hypothesis suggests they might be evidence that our universe is periodically debugging itself. Many of us can recall a time when we entered a new environment and were struck by an uncanny sense of familiarity. It was as if we'd stepped into a scene that we were meant to know, even though we'd never been there before. Moments like these raise the question, could these feelings be the result of our simulation momentarily rewinding or recalculating its code? Before you start worrying about the stability of your reality, here's an important thought. Whether or not our universe is simulated, our experiences, emotions, and choices are still genuine. Even if our world were just a digital construct, it wouldn't necessarily strip our lives of meaning. After all, even in a video game, the stories we share, the challenges we overcome, and the connections we forge are real in their impact on us. So, what's the bottom line? Even if we were characters in a cosmic simulation, our actions would matter, both to us and possibly to the mysterious creators running the show. We might be subject to the whims of a higher intelligence, or we might simply be part of an elaborate experiment designed to mimic reality as closely as possible. Either way, the uncertainty of our true nature should not diminish our appreciation for the beauty, complexity, and wonder of the world we experience. At the end of the day, simulation theory is as much philosophical thought as it is scientific hypothesis. It invites us to ask, what is real? How do we define existence? And if everything we know is programmed, does that free us from the weight of destiny? Or does it challenge us to live even more intentionally? After all, whether our universe is a simulation or not, it's our only home. A reality that we shape with every thought, every choice, and every heartbeat. I like to think of it like this. Maybe all this thought exercise is just a way for us to see things from a different angle. The nature of reality seems too vast to be understood with our limited perception of the universe. It's a question we have asked ourselves for ages. Why are we here? This theory is yet another attempt to bring our human minds closer to the ultimate meaning, the most sought-after answer. An answer that could finally bring us together as one with this majestic and magical miracle of a universe we share. A universe that keeps on debugging itself when no one's looking. Thank you for joining us on this mind-bending journey here on The Life Pulse. If you enjoyed this exploration into simulation theory, please hit the like button, share your thoughts in the comments below, and subscribe for more engaging and thought-provoking content. Until next time, keep your mind open, stay positive and curious. Enjoy the ride and stay safe. See you in the next render.